capable of approximately 186 miles an hour, 0 to 60 in 4.2 seconds. Beautiful example, it's owned by Nick Mason, the drummer from Pink Floyd, who's one of our trustees there. And he has such a wonderful collection of vehicles, he tends to lend us variety. This isn't the only car that is on display today. As I say, it's go on, Dad. Okay, so that's a 4.2 litre V8 from 2008. 186 mile an hour top speed. Okay, going around now on display for Bentley Hampshire, our local Bentley dealership, is this absolutely glorious, brand spanking new Bentley Continental Super Sports convertible. This is the fastest convertible car money can buy. It does 0-60 in 3.9 seconds, 0-100 in under 10 seconds, it does 204 miles an hour, but it's a typical Bentley in every respect. It's beautifully built, and the quality is beyond compare, and it is a true supercar, a gentleman's sports car, capable of going across Europe. A real grand tour, but it has all the performance you could ever ask for. As I say, it's particularly nice to have the very latest super sports next to our 1930 Burberry. So thank you, David. If you'd like to see the car in more detail, do come round after the campaign to have a look. David, we'd be delighted to talk to you all about it. Okay, making its way around, not too subtly, I must admit, is this McLaren F1 GTR. This is also owned by Nick Mason, the drummer from Pink Floyd and our trustee. It has 0-60 and decent speed, I think it's 3.5 seconds. V12 engine, and if you look closely, you may actually notice the driver is sitting in the middle. There are three seats in this, one either side of the driver, and the driver sitting in the middle, which I suppose saves conversion from left to right of the car. This is the GTR, this is not the standard this one. The standard car has 620 brake horse from V12. This being the racing car has a further 60 brake horses, 680 brake horsepower. Display normally of you, it's in the hands of a private sector. It has a 2.4 litre V6, capable of developing 195 brake horsepower. Capable of 150 miles an hour, it costs you, 1974, £6,245. So that was a pretty expensive car in its day, but it's a highly desirable latest car. I'm not taking it. Okay, next up is another V6 car. This is the Nissan Skyline GTR from 2009. Now, you wouldn't necessarily normally imagine that Nissan were capable of manufacturing supercars, but this really is a walking chew's clothing. It's a four-seater car, yet it's capable of 195 miles an hour. It's got a 3.8-litre V6, and it does 0 to 60 in 3.5 seconds. In standard trim, that's 500 brake horsepower. And in typical Japanese style, it is absolutely loaded to the gunnels with every electronic technical gizmo you could ever imagine. So this is a local car driven by Jonathan Grassi, and on his next tour around I'm going to stop him and ask him to tell you a few more details about it, because it is quite a magnificent vehicle, and he knows more about it than I do. Okay, Jonathan, a few details from you, please. Tell us a bit more about your car.
It's a 209. It's one of the first cars in the UK. I use it as an everyday car, and as a practical single car, it's a second to none. It's very easily tunable, so quite a lot of guys are giving these up to 700-800 brake horsepower, and the speed of those cars is on par with the Veyron. So it's an everyday car, outstanding performance. Fuel that's on is Dr. Fox.
Is this your first single car?
It's probably the fastest car I've had. I've had a few other cars that are relatively exciting, but this is my first very, very fast.
Thank you very much indeed, Jonathan
Grassi. Tell them what they are. Sounds of 10 miles on
earth. Okay, next up is 1997 Porsche 993 model 911 Turbo S. It has a flat 6 engine, 3.6 litres, that develops 285 brake horsepower, and does 0-60 in 5.2 seconds. Top speed is the wrong side of 170 miles an hour, but in typical Porsche style, it's understated, it's entirely manageable, and it's a genuine supercar. This car is also local, and we're delighted to see it cruising here today. Last of the range that actually had the flat 6, 3.6 litre engine. Okay, the next car barking into life is an Aston Martin Vanquish S, which up until 10 minutes before the cavalcade started was indeed going to be lit. The owner, delighted driver, came and said, "Oh, would you like to have a great family meeting with the Vanquish S?" And the answer was an obvious yes. The owner is Rocky Ferdinand. The car is capable of 204 miles an hour. Exciting to be the wrong side of 200. It's 0 to 60 in 4 seconds, and it has a 560 brake horsepower engine. It's one of the last Vanquish S's made. We're really delighted. And you're really delighted to see it out here.